13 camping hacks that will save your life. Number 13. Waterproof shoes. Keeping your shoes dry seems like a luxury when you're trying to survive in harsh conditions, but it's actually much more important than you might think. If your feet get cold, you get cold, plain and simple. Wet feet can lead to unwanted fungal infections like athlete's foot, and often lead to other infections. If you have any excess lip balm or any petroleum-based products, use it to seal the seams in your shoes, keeping them resistant to water while marching around the woods. Number 12. A makeshift oil lamp. Staying warm in the wilderness is always important. Unfortunately, you're not going to find any air conditionings or heating devices in the forest, besides maybe some bears willing to cuddle up next to you. Instead, you're going to need to use some fire. You didn't pack any candles with you, but for some reason, you happen to have some olive oil, a lighter, a Kleenex, and an empty Coke can. This is actually all you need. Pour the Coke can about halfway full of olive oil, insert your Kleenex, and light it on fire. This will actually burn a lot longer than you'd want to think. And there you have it, your Italian oil lantern. Number 11. Makeshift microwave. Ever wish you can bring a microwave with you on your next camping trip? It would make life so much easier. For this next one, all you need is a cereal box, aluminum foil, and a sunny day. First, you want to cut the cereal box so it can open. Aluminum foil has been known to help people get tans. It's normally not something you want to put in your microwave, but this time it's okay. Wrap inside with aluminum foil and wrap the inner part of the box as well. When you're done, it should look something like this photo. Place the food inside and give it quite a bit of time. It's best to try something like a grilled cheese sandwich before possibly using it to cook meat from a giant bear you hunted with your bare hands. Number 10. Aluminum foil uses. In addition to the makeshift microwave, aluminum foil can be an extremely useful tool the next time you go hiking. It's so versatile, you can make it into almost anything you really want to. You need to lure in some fish? Grab your aluminum foil. You need something to stay dry? Cover it in aluminum foil. Don't feel like lugging a huge frying pan with you into the woods? Make one out of aluminum foil. Think the government is trying to hack into your brain and need to protect yourself against them reading your thoughts? Aluminum foil will also solve this problem. The point is, aluminum foil is your ally, so don't forget to bring plenty of it next time you go camping. Number 9. Improvised pillow. While going camping, many people might focus on the main things that they need while camping. Things like tents are of course important, as well as comfy sleeping bags. But one thing that many people tend to forget about is their pillow. Getting bad sleep can result in many bad side effects, such as aching muscles and joints, chronic health issues like heart disease and strokes, depression, and a whole slew of negative side effects you don't want to risk. Make sure you bring a pillow. If you take your bag of your sleeping bag, fill it with clothes, you got yourself a quick pillow. Stuffing it with something like a fleece jacket works great. Number 8. Duct tape treatment. Not only will duct tape keep your victims well bound while you're trying to find a place in the forest to leave them, it'll also help you close a wound they might have inflicted on you in defense. Oh right, this is camping hacks, not kidnapping hacks. Either way, duct tape can possibly save your life if you've been wounded. You're completely out of band-aids, a small strip will do the trick. Just get a piece of tissue and place it in the middle of the strip, so don't forget to use this in case of emergency, and it'll stop the bleeding. Number 7. Fire starter. Did you know that lint in your dryer is extremely flammable? This is actually the perfect ingredient to bring with you on your next camping trip. If you really need to get a fire going and don't have a gallon of gasoline with you, use some lint. Lint can be perfectly stored in an empty toilet paper roll. Use this camping hack and you got one of the best campfire starters around. Number 6. Pancakes to go. Okay, you got your fire going with some sweet lint toilet paper rolls. Now you're ready for the fun to begin. But hold on a minute. Someone didn't bring all the ingredients for pancakes. No way. You don't have to worry about your camping trip getting ruined like this. All you gotta do is grab yourself an empty ketchup bottle, fill it with pancake or flapjack pre-made batter, and you got yourself a pretty sweet way to make them. All you gotta do is squeeze it on the pan et voila. Just be sure to keep the mix cool so the eggs won't cause salmonella. Number 5. Keeping the bears away. We discussed in our survival tips video about what to do if you encounter an angry bear. First thing you should really do is consider getting yourself what's known as a bear bag. Hopefully, this will keep the bears from invading your tent like we see in this photo. If all goes as planned, the bear won't be able to smell that you have a picnic going on. If you're hunting, don't carry on to dead animals for too long. This makes you prime targets for bears. Bears will just eat about anything, not just honey like we've seen from the Winnie and Pooh show. Bears' sense of smell is so keen that they can even smell the chewing gum in your mouth. Number 4. A brighter tent. We all love camping during a full moon, unless there's a werewolf, of course. The moonlight definitely keeps things brighter, but follow a few tips and you can have your tent as bright as possible. Grab an empty milk jug, fill it with water, then place it next to the flashlight head. If you want a cool, crazy green color, you can bring a 2-liter of Sprite or 7-Up that's normally green and place a flashlight next to that. And just like that, your tent will glow like magic and help you spot angry animals and will somehow save your life. Number 3. Bra hack. Ladies, here's your chance to finally put those bras to good use. Especially now that you're in the middle of the wilderness, no one's checking to see if you're wearing one or not. In case of a random forest fire, use those boulder holders as a debris mask. It'll keep you from inhaling dust and hazardous ash into your lungs. The number one cause of death from fires isn't from being burned to death, it's from smoke inhalation. The severely hot particles of gas and dust can cause you to stop breathing. Don't take that chance. You might just want to make sure it's washed first, though. Number 2. Natural bug repellent. Mosquitoes host some fairly serious diseases that you really don't want to catch, especially during your next camping trip. Diseases like yellow fever, West Nile virus, malaria, and even Zika. If you don't bring your bug repellent, it could be your very last hiking trip ever. Luckily, there is one natural bug repellent you can use. Get a hold of some dry sage leaves and hang them around your tent. Bugs hate these plants, which means you'll love them. It's also much more natural than dealing with all those nasty chemicals. Make sure you use the right leaves though, and not poison ivy. And number 1. Fire starter hacks. Not everything will catch fire, and you'll learn this as you're trying to start one. While your best chance of starting a fire is using your cell phone battery, it's understandable that many people might be hesitant of this. There's 3 other things you can use. Ladies, one of them is probably in your purse right now. The multifunctional tool known as the tampon can start a fire pretty easily. First, rip it in several pieces, and the cotton material can be used as tinder. The second one is a pencil sharpener. The shavings from pencil sharpeners are highly flammable, and you can probably use a twig instead of a pencil. Cow dung has been used for centuries as a fire starter, and it will burn. Many countries still use it to this day, including India. Cows are vegetarians, and once it's dry, it doesn't smell as bad as you would think.